Hi folks, we're here in Namma Bengaluru and we're shooting this episode, which is not a typical Gourmet on the Road episode, but something different for a change. So I've just stepped out of my office for lunch and there is this place that I go to typically for lunch maybe twice in a month. I thought I would share with you what a typical lunch is like for me when I'm not shooting an episode of Gourmet on the Road. So stick around till the end to find out more. So we're at Fava Bistro in Koramangla and this is one of my favorite lunch spots when we're not shooting Gourmet on the Road, when we're not traveling out there. What I like about this place is that it's usually not too crowded, which in a way is also unfortunate because I'll tell you about what's happening with this place in some time. But the food here that I always order is, it's fresh, it's wholesome. And it's not really the kind of food that weighs you down after you've eaten it. So that's the reason why I like Fava Bistro. So we're going to order a few of the dishes that I typically would eat. Of course, when I come on my own, I would order one of those dishes. But because we're doing this episode, because we're doing this review, and because I have my team here, who will also share the food with me, we're going to taste a few of the dishes that I typically order at Fava Bistro. So we will do the lamb kebab and avocado wrap, the hummus. So we'll do the Fava Bistro hamburger with the grilled bacon. Mango Caesar salad as well. I would also like to do the chicken peri peri. So as you can see, there are a bunch of dishes here. So one of the dishes that I would typically order here is the labneh or the hung yogurt, which is sweetened with honey. And then they also have some wilted spinach that it's served with, along with some toasted almonds on top. And there's a bit of paprika that you see that is sprinkled on top. The other dish that I would also order is the hummus, the classical hummus. I like the way they plate it here with those twirls of hummus with some microgreens on top and some warm pita bread. And that's really what I'm going to start my meal with. Nothing as comforting as warm pita bread. I think I'm going to just taste the labneh first just by itself. You know, the labneh, the yogurt has just the perfect balance of sour and that hint of sweet that comes from the honey. There's also some garlic in it which gives it that bite. I think the garlic comes from the wilted spinach. I'm going to taste some of the labneh, the spinach, and also some toasted almond. You taste that spinach in its slight bitter bite. We'll taste the pita, the labneh, and the spinach. You get a crunch of the toasted almond. It's creamy flavor punctuated by the sweetness of the honey. And then you've got the peppery bite of the arugula. Delicious. Next, I'm going to taste the hummus. The hummus which is spiked with a bit of paprika. You know, the hummus is light and creamy. And you taste that chickpea. So sometimes when you're tasting hummus, you definitely taste a lot of the chickpea, but you also need that tahini or the sesame paste that goes into the hummus to balance it nicely. And this is a classic example of a hummus that's well prepared. Hummus the pita and some microgreens. So when I come here and I order the labne and I order the hummus and you have some pita, that's a delicious, well-balanced lunch. So you've got some carbs that come from the pita, you've got the protein that comes from the chickpea, the yogurt that's in there, and of course you also have the goodness of the veggies in the spinach. And some toasted nuts, just for that added crunch and flavor. So good. So there are days when I feel like a salad, and on those days I will typically have a salad. A salad that I'm always partial to is the Caesar salad, and they do a good Caesar salad here. But this salad, this particular variation of the Caesar salad, I haven't eaten before. This is a Caesar salad, and because mangoes are in season, they've got some mangoes in the Caesar salad. If I'm feeling like a really light meal, I will just order a salad and maybe a soup to go with it. Or there are times when I will oomph up my salad with bacon, with chicken, and with a lot of the Parmesan cheese that goes on top to really make that salad a substantial light meal. But today I'm going to have the Caesar salad just in the manner that they would typically serve it. So you've got the lettuce here, you've got the iceberg lettuce, you've got the romaine lettuce, you've got, of course, the customary croutons. You know, I hate it when a salad is overdressed, but this one is just perfect. The sweetest mangoes that I've eaten, and in a salad of all things. I'm going to try and combine the lettuce with the dressing and the mango and one of the croutons into one bite, just so that I get all the ingredients, I get all the flavors, and I get all the texture in one go. Now there are some days when I don't feel like a salad and I feel like ordering something sumptuous yet quick because I'm in the middle of work. And those are the days that I will typically go for the wraps that they do here. This is a lamb kebab and avocado wrap that they do here, and I'm a big fan of the wraps that they do here. What I like is the weight of this wrap. You hold this wrap and you know it's got all sorts of goodness stuffed into it. So this one has the lamb, it has an avocado salsa, there's some labne in it. There's also some greens, I can see some tomatoes, some onions that have gone into it as well. It's a sort of wrap that is wholesome and will leave you happily satisfied. And the wrap is typically served with the garlic sauce and the harissa. So typically they would serve this with fries or with potato wedges or baby potatoes. But since I've got all the carbs that I need in the wrap, I will usually order mine with grilled veggies. So you've got all sorts of veggies. I've got broccoli, I've got some zucchini, carrots, I even got some eggplant here. They are grilled nicely, and that's typically what I will have. It's a nicely spiced lamb kebab. You taste the labne, so you get that nice yogurt creaminess that kind of comes together, and then you get the crunch of the vegetables. You got the avocado salsa that's oozing out of the wrap. I made a mess of myself, but then this is what a meal is like sometimes. It's a wrap made of whole wheat, and the wrap does enough just to hold all the ingredients within. And I think that's the beautiful thing about this wrap. It's wholesome, healthy, delicious, and a wrap that will keep you content for a few hours. So I don't ask for the fries, I don't ask for the baby potatoes or the wedges. I ask for the grilled vegetables. That's how I get my vegetables for the day. The vegetables are grilled just fine, lightly seasoned, and with the right crunch. These two dishes define two extremes of a typical lunch. So there are days when I feel like I want to eat light, and there are days when I feel that I shouldn't be eating any carbs, just that probably I've kind of done a few tastings or probably had a heavy meal the previous evening. I'll come to Fava Bistro and eat something like this. Now this is a very simple chicken peri peri. It's a breast of chicken which is marinated in a spicy peri-peri sauce. I typically ask the chef to do whatever sauce he would like to do. I think this time they've got a barbecue sauce here. And I just ask for some grilled vegetables like they have served right here. Of course, then there are certain days where I think my appetite gets the better of me. And those are the days that I go for the hamburger here. This is a no apologies, full-on loaded burger. The good thing is they've got a multigrain bun, which is nice. So there's some wholesomeness to the bun here. So I think I'm going to begin with the chicken peri peri. It's a nice single breast of chicken. I like the way the chicken has been marinated well in the peri peri marinade. So it's going to have that nice spicy sort of a touch. You look at this piece of chicken and you know that it's moist. It's not going to be that dry sort of a chicken. The chicken is perfectly marinated in the peri-peri, and that peri-peri does assert itself in its spice, which gets you at the back of the throat. But then you have the sweet notes of the barbecue sauce that takes over. And the chicken is nice and moist. It's a flavorful chicken dish. I'm going to have my chicken now with some veggies, a little kebab of sorts. I've got the zucchini, I've got the chicken, I've got some more zucchini, and I've got some peppers. Because I think the chicken here is soaked in the right amount of marinade, and the barbecue sauce that's been gently napped on top is just enough to relish this dish just as it is. A beautiful dish if you like your chicken. I'm going to put my fork and knife aside because I'm going to present to you the multigrain burger. Now this, as I said earlier, is a dish that I will order on those rare occasions when I'm feeling really hungry, when I feel that I need something to sustain me for an extended period of time. Since I've tasted all these dishes, I've requested the chef to split up the burger. This will also hopefully allow us to explore the build of the burger. So as you can see, you've got the brioche, the multigrain burger bun, you've got the bacon, you've got the patty, and then you have all the veggies and the caramel onions that's right there. So this is a loaded burger. I've already eaten a lot of food doing this tasting, but looking at something like this right here, you can see the juices of the meat patty. This is going to be a tasty bite. Mmm. you can taste the flavors emerge through each layer of this burger. So you've got that intense, fatty, savoriness of the bacon. You've got the saltiness that comes from the cheddar. You've got that juicy, meaty patty. And then you have the sweetness that emerges from the caramelized onions. And then, of course, you've got the fresh crunch of all the vegetables. This is as close to perfection that you can get in a burger. This is so good. And not to forget this multigrain bun. It's got just the right amount of strength to hold all the elements of the burger within. If you look at the multigrain bun, it's not crumbling away. It's strong enough to hold the meat, to hold the bacon, to hold the relish, to hold the pickle, to hold all the vegetables that are there inside this burger. This is the sort of burger that you will really dig if you're a burger lover. I can't fault this burger on any ground whatsoever. You know, while I'm eating here today and I'm presenting this to you, of course, I've presented to you all the dishes that I typically order at lunch. Once again, I don't order all of these when I'm doing lunch. I would order one of these usually. If I'm doing a salad, maybe a salad and a soup. But I also wanted to present this for another reason, and this is a slightly sad reason. This is perhaps my last meal at Fava Bistro here in Koramangla. As I mentioned earlier, one of the things that's really nice about this restaurant, whenever you come here, you find a place to sit. It's not too busy. It's not bustling. But then, from a restaurateur's perspective, that's not good for business, is it? And so therefore, over the next few days, and perhaps even before this video is showcased, Fava Bistro will close. So it's kind of like a bittersweet moment for me. I'm happy that I got to taste all these dishes once again, and more importantly, present them to you. But knowing that this is perhaps my last meal here at Fava Bistro. But then such are the challenges for restaurants these days. It's very easy to go into a restaurant, pass judgment, go online, post a review, good, bad, ugly. But the restaurateurs deal with enormous challenges day in and day out. And it takes a great deal of things to come together to make that restaurant work. And that's the reason why I have the highest appreciation and highest regard for anybody who's involved in the restauranting business. It looks glamorous, it looks glitzy, it looks very appealing from the outside. But on the inside, it's tough work. And there are so many variables that they need to contend with. And sometimes, despite doing all that they need to do, despite opening a great space, despite serving great food, it just isn't enough. So I'm going to miss Fava Bistro for lunch. I'm going to miss Fava Bistro for the space that it is. I'm going to miss Fava Bistro for the great team that's running the show here. And I'm going to miss Fava Bistro for all the delicious meals that I've had here thus far. I think the community will miss Fava Bistro, but then, as they say, life goes on. I hope you enjoyed this presentation of what I would typically eat for lunch every once in a while. Until the next episode of Gourmet on the Road, happy eating. I'm going to go back to my burger. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to subscribe, share and leave a comment. If you'd like to support Food Lovers TV, do log on to foodlovers.in and hit the support Food Lovers banner. Links in the description below. Happy eating!